Hi there, guys. This is Dan Dix here reporting for Press for Truth. We are in beautiful Acapulco at the second annual Anarchapulco Conference, and I am joined right now by the one and only Larken WAS. Sir, thank you very much for taking some time to speak with us today.
No problem.
Now, first of all, I just watched your talk. Fantastic talk. It almost seems like you're kind of coming out of retirement almost to give this talk, and that is fantastic that people are very happy about, but it was kind of based around such a small thing. What in a nutshell is the small thing that everyone needs to be aware of?
Well, the so small a thing that's basically the thing in the way of a civilized society and a moral humanity is the belief in authority. And the people imagining that there's such thing as a rightful ruling class, and as long as they think that, as long as they're bickering over, well, who should sit on the throne and who should he beat up and why, we don't ever get to peaceful coexistence. That road doesn't lead there. The road that leads there is saying, how about nobody on a throne? How about don't have a throne? And it's, in one sense, it's a very small superstition to give up, but it's a big challenge for people who have lived their whole lives sort of thinking government's the solution to everything and that political power and democracy, that saves the day, and they don't recognize that's actually the enemy of humanity. And that's what has to be done away with, is the belief that that's the source of society is a violent ruling class. And no, it isn't. That's the biggest problem.
Well, how do we go about breaking that down to people, especially with the propaganda being so thick and the conditioning and the brainwashing and everybody being in love with the state? How do we break through that barrier, because they've been heavily propagandized? What are the ways that we can enlighten some of these people?
Well, of course, there's a lot of different people trying a lot of different things. There's all sorts of books and videos and, debating and arguing, and then just people talking one-on-one. My current thing is a huge project I have called The Mirror, which is an interactive way that somebody can basically look through their own belief system and find out that they may very well be betraying who they really are and what their values really are, because they were taught things that they took on faith that don't match what they really believe in and what they think the world should be, and they were just sort of tricked into believing things that are messing with their heads. So it isn't, we're not in a world full of 8 billion individually malicious people, or we'd just be doomed. Mostly, most of the oppression, most of the war, most of that comes from authoritarianism. It comes from the indoctrination. If the indoctrination is fixed, we all get along fine. And so we don't need to change the nature of mankind. We just need to remove one really big lie. And of course, there's a bunch of different ways people try to do that. And my project, The Mirror, is the huge one that I'm working on now. But the more the merrier.
It seems the term itself is often really misconstrued amongst the masses. That is, with people thinking that it's going to mean chaos or no rules. Where do they have it wrong there? What is it? What's the truth of it all?
Well, people are so used to thinking inside the statist paradigm of, like, what government should do and who should it take care of and who should it punish and what laws should it do. When you talk about anarchy, when you talk about doing away with government, often they jump to the conclusion that you mean whatever the government does right now, nobody's going to do that. And that's not at all what it means. Like I just said in my talk, all it really means is we don't give anyone an exemption from morality. Because that's all the belief in authority is. It's saying those people, they're not like the rest of us. They're allowed to boss us around. They're allowed to take our money. They're allowed to rule us, basically. And anarchism just says nobody's allowed to do that. We're still allowed to organize. We can cooperate. We can do a million different solutions to a million different problems. But nobody gets to force their ideas onto other people. That the only time force is justified is to defend yourself from an attacker. And calling it law or taxation or authority doesn't make force okay. So the only thing anarchism removes is the idea that some people are allowed to do bad stuff, are allowed to attack you and control you. Right. And that's all. And we don't need that for anything.
Right. So we are seeing, as you demonstrated in your talk, a pretty big rise in the amount of people coming to this realization. Where would you like to see this go? In the coming weeks or months or even years, what would you like to see come of your past 20 years worth of work on this?
Well, I'm already just thrilled to death because, like you said, I've been an anarchist for 20 years, and the first 10 or so years, almost nobody paid attention. I assumed, well, I'll just be babbling until I'm blue in the face and nobody will pay attention. But in recent years, it's grown exponentially. It's been amazing, and it continues to grow, and it's contagious. Because when somebody grasps the feeling of self-ownership and freedom and the fact that I'm really in charge of my life, there is the responsibility side, which can be a little bit scary, but people want to share that to other people so other people can be adult, you know, responsible human, self-owning human beings too. And I think at the rate it's been spreading, if that continues, it's not going to be centuries until we see a very different world. It might be decades, but it's going to happen fast, and faster than a whole lot of people would expect, way faster than I would have expected 20 years ago.
Well, it is on the fast track right now, exponentially growing. For people who are watching this right now and saying, yeah, what he says makes a lot of sense to me, where can they go to learn more from you, maybe purchase your books, or learn more about your upcoming project?
Well, there's my YouTube channel, which is just youtube.com/LarkinRose. There's also LarkinRose.com, and my books are on Amazon, the main book being The Most Dangerous Superstition, and then my novel, The Iron Web. But and I'm on Facebook arguing with people constantly. But YouTube is, you know, I have a bunch of videos there, and some of them are collaborations. And a lot of times just a short, simple video that explains one little thing will suddenly get somebody to think, yeah, that sort of goes against everything I was always taught, but it kind of makes sense. And that's how I got there. I was a statist for many years and just eventually looked at my own belief system and said, yeah, there's problems in there. There are contradictions in my own head. I don't want them there. And that's how I ended up here, totally by accident, just by hacking out the contradictions.
Well, final thought, what are your thoughts on Anarchapoco? You know, the second annual world's now largest anarchy conference. How do you think it's going?
Oh, it's been great. And I'm glad I got nagged into coming down here and did it. And I've been hanging around talking to a whole bunch of different people. And it's so encouraging to see this many people from, you know, different backgrounds, and they have different approaches and different, you know, attitudes and everything else. But we all have this one thing in common, that we want peaceful coexistence. And that's kind of what matters. We don't all have to be the same. We just all have to not attack each other. And so to see this diverse group of people talking about everything under the sun, and, you know, of course, the location here is amazing too. It's just it's a very unusual and cool event to be at. And 10 years ago, I wouldn't have thought that I would ever be among this many people who have given up their statism. And so that's just amazing to see.
And peaceful coexistence, folks, is something that's hard to argue with. So, you know, we'll stick with that one. Once again, Larken, thank you for talking to us.
Thank you.